Life in the 21st century. A world of constant change. Here, people were born. Here, people died. This was considered an inevitable fact of life until people began to ask, what if they didn't have to? What if they could live forever?
You live against the truth of the universe, you know. If you have a family, you're aware that your children will someday die, but you don't treat them as dead. You treat them as living creatures that you have to nurture. And I think the same is true of your own life, that you're aware it's finite, you're aware that you'll only have a certain amount of time, but we don't live with it because it's not in the way we're wired to live with that.
Every human is born ignorant of death, believing that life has no end. But when you learn the truth, how do you go on?
People want to show that they existed. And so they may do that biologically by producing other offspring. They may do it by creating something.
I think of death as a disease. I think it's a disease that's possibly curable and potentially and likely curable. So it's like asking me the question, am I at peace that cancer exists? You know, am I at peace that this disease that killed my father exists? No, I'm not at peace with that.
The will to live propelled humans to fight against their inescapable decay. They dreamed of a brighter future, free from their body's limitations.
I have often wished there were like 14 clones of me because there's so many things I'd like to do.
Like if someone could say, hey, we downloaded your mom's brain and you can talk to her for it, I would do that. I think that'd be good for people that are mourning a family member's death, to have that around, maybe.
Maybe at the beginning of life, you would implant a chip in someone's back or cortex that someday can be used to form the brain and personality and the knowledge of that human.
If we're able to get that consciousness and upload it, then all this is not me anymore. It's what's up right here.
While immortality remained a distant dream, science brought us closer.
There was a time when there would have been nothing creepier than the notion of in vitro fertilization, and a test tube baby was considered an abomination. Things that are creepy or weird, whatever word we want to use, they change over time in society.
We discovered new and ingenious ways to prolong life. But could the human species achieve the impossible?
It's coming, there's no question about it. Probably coming sooner than we think. There are colossal implications, obviously, at every level of society. It's going to change everything. But technology always does. That's not in itself anything new. And I think the key is not to be afraid of it.
Once we decode the language of the brain and connect that to a machine, then we can capture and store the essence of a person as data.
We're looking at the end of our bodies as a permanent residence. Imagine someone who is at the peak of their physical prowess and then just stays that way.
This future was closer than they realized. Scientists were already at the threshold of a new era in human evolution. What innovations are still to come? What dreams of immortality have yet to be fulfilled? What will become of the human species? Thanks to Psych-A-Sec, we'll be around to find out. Here's to the next 300 years. 300.
The danger of living too many times. You forget to fear death.